Welcome to this lecture, everybody. In this video, we are going to pick up where we left off in the last video by changing the node values and settings in order to create a shader which is similar or sort of identical to the render on the left. We can start by selecting a viewport render border with Shift-B and setting the shading to Cycles Viewport Rendering. Then we can change the mapping node settings of all three mapping nodes as shown. Now I am basically gonna change the nodes row by row. In the next two videos, we will experiment with the nodes to get different looks. After recording the last video, I discovered that the highlighted nodes are actually obsolete, so we can delete them. We can change all three color ramp settings to be spline. We can also quickly modify the values in this noise texture node. We can bring the two handles of the first color ramp node closer together as shown. Then we can add extra handles on the second color ramp node and give the ones colors like I do. Observe that two handles on the far left and far right needs to be black. Since I am a fan of Superman, I am gonna give the two handles in the middle the color red and blue. Now we can select and then delete the third color ramp node and duplicate the second color ramp node to take its place. And suddenly the shader transforms into one more of our liking. We can tweak the values of this noise texture node a little to see what we can improve. Of course, it is ultimately up to you to choose the settings you best see fit for your shader. This shader is a bit render intensive, so that is why you will see me using a smaller preview render border. We can duplicate the top color ramp node and a matte multiply node and place them below the bottom color ramp node and make the connections as I do. We do this to make a better fading effect, which we can control better with the multiply value and the color ramp handles. Now we will use the top color ramp node as a vector to mix the two color ramp nodes below it. To make the effect clear to see, we will first put the setting to constant. Then we can start changing the colors of the middle two handles of our third color ramp node. We can put this color mix node setting to add instead of mix. We can see that the transition is sharp in the preview render. We can change the setting on the top color ramp node to ease or be spline, since we are going to want a smooth transition. We can also experiment with the scale value of the connected noise texture. Let's give this handle a red color to more easily discern the contrast between the colors of the two color ramp nodes. Here you can see the purple and blue color with soft transition due to B-spline setting on the top color ramp node. Now I am just going to let you watch me play with the colors to get some nice looks. I recommend you do the same on your end. I do advise you not to move the handles that were already given a black color too much. Also leave them black, especially the ones on the left side. You can also move the colored handles a little bit to shift the color border more outwards or inwards. Just experiment a little and you will learn from this process as well. Also, don't forget to experiment with the noise note connected to the top color ramp note. By moving the left handle on the bottom color ramp note, you can adjust the fading to black on the edge of your sphere. So I think I am done playing with the colors for this video. I think our shader looks good, so I'm gonna leave it as it is. I suggest you to save this file as a separate blend file, as you should do after each video, so that you can always come back to review your steps in the creation process. In the next video, we are gonna create the black center of the shader, which will be done with a separate object. Well, thank you for watching and see you in the next video.